In this video, I will use the example of an Onkyo TX NR737 AV receiver from 2014 to show how a defect on the HDMI board can be repaired easily and inexpensively. The error in the HDMI board typically manifests itself in the fact that the Onkyo at the HDMI main output, as can be seen here, no longer provides an image for the television. The cause of the error are capacitors on the HDMI board that age over time and lose their performance. My goal with this video is to show how the lifespan of great devices can be increased and the production of electronic waste reduced. For the Onkyo receiver, the service manual with circuit diagrams is available on the internet and the link inserted in the show notes. Two capacitors must be replaced on the front and five capacitors on the rear of the HDMI board. The capacitors are used for the function of the integrated circuits DAC, digital analog converter, and DIX, digital audio interface transceiver. The links to the data sheets of the two integrated circuits are also shown in the show notes. The capacitors to be replaced are marked in the circuit diagram. Let's take a quick look at how DAC and DIX work. The datasheet of the digital to analog converter shows how it works in the application diagram. The DAC's task is to convert digital signals into analog signals. The functionality of the DIX is also shown in the application diagram. The DIX is used for routing the signals of the connected channels. If one of these two integrated circuits fails, the signals from the connected devices is no longer processed in the Onkyo receiver. Let's go shopping. In this case, electrolytic capacitors are chosen to replace the built-in aluminum capacitors. One advantage of electrolytic capacitors is that damage is indicated by a bulge on the top. Damage is not visible on the aluminum capacitors currently installed. It can be assumed that more capacitors have lost power over time, therefore all seven capacitors are exchanged. When selecting the new capacitors, care is taken that the same capacitance is used and the same or a higher voltage. Further, selection criteria are a long service life of at least 2000 hours and a temperature of at least 105 degrees Celsius. The larger these two values are, the better. The price for all seven capacitors, including shipping, is approximately 10 euro. In my case, I ordered the components directly from the branch and picked them up there. Costs could be reduced to approximately 4 euro. I picked up the delivery at the branch and the repair can begin. The following equipment is required for the repair: a screwdriver, a pliers, a soldering iron with approximately 35 watts and a holder, as well as solder and solder grease. To open the Onkyo, you have to loosen three screws on both sides and two screws on the back. After loosening the screws, the housing cover is removed. After opening the housing, I recommend using a camera to take a few pictures of the wiring inside the Onkyo. These pictures can prove to be very helpful when you later assemble the receiver. To remove the fan, loosen two screws on the back. The cable connector from the fan is removed with the pliers and the fan is removed. The capacitors to be replaced are installed on the front and back of the HDMI board. The HDMI board must be completely removed from the Onkyo. The connections are removed from the HDMI board with the pliers. The two ribbon connectors are carefully pulled out of the holder by hand. On the back, 8 screws above the HDMI inputs and outputs are loosened. After loosening the last screw, the HDMI board can be carefully pulled out of the holder. The board is held from below by a plastic pin next to the power supply. This pin is pressed together with the pliers and the board can be removed completely. A look at the front of the HDMI board. The first two aluminum capacitors to be replaced can be seen on the right. The black border on the capacitor marks the ground or the negative connection. The old capacitor made of aluminum is released with the pliers by slowly moving it back and forth from the two soldered feet and lifted off. This movement should be carried out carefully and with a little feeling so as not to damage the solder pads on the board. The new capacitor is soldered in. For this, the feet are bent over with pliers. Tinned with soldering grease and tin. The soldering iron is heated with the soldering iron and the capacitor is soldered on. After the first fixation, the solder joint is filled with additional solder. The second aluminum capacitor is removed using the pliers method shown previously and without a soldering iron. The second capacitor has been removed and the new capacitor is also soldered in. The picture shows the result afterwards. On the back of the HDMI board, the 5 capacitors are exchanged according to the same principle. Here the 5 capacitors are shown enlarged. The old aluminum capacitors are removed from the circuit board using the well-known pliers method. The new electrolytic capacitors are soldered in place of the old aluminum capacitors. The bent feet of the capacitors can be seen from the side. The picture shows the results afterwards. We are done and can put the OnQ back together. When you plug in the cable connector, it might now become clear why it was advisable to take a photo of the wiring inside beforehand. I use pliers to attach the plugs to hard-to-reach places. The 8 screws are reinserted on the back. The fan is inserted and the connector is plugged in again. The bracket is attached to the back with 2 screws. The Onkyo device is closed and screwed again. The Onkyo receiver is reset to the factory settings by pressing the key combination cable set and on standby. The reset may take some seconds. After pressing on standby, the Onkyo starts in the setup mode. After switching on the television, the Onkyo will display the OSD on-screen display. Great! The repair worked. My personal opinion is that this solution presented is not long-term. The capacitors can fail again after a while due to overheating. Therefore, in one of my new projects, the Onkyo will be equipped with an integrated and temperature-dependent air cooling. So subscribe to my channel so as not to miss my new project. I hope you enjoyed the video and I'm looking forward to your comments and I'm happy with a thumbs up.